I just want to show a close-up of the Westie. This is the ears and the face. Here's the body. And around here's the back of the Westie. What's nice about the Westie is I made it so that the legs go up and down. So you can move the legs. So it can stand up. Or it can sit. So now I'm going to also show a video of the Westie with the accessories. I just wanted to show a close-up of the Westie and the hat and the beautiful scarf, striped scarf. You can add more hair if you want around the body. This is what it looks like behind. And of course, the hat and the scarf are removable. I'm going to go ahead and take off the hat just to show you what the head looks like. The yarn that I'm using, one of them is Red Heart Super Saver Jumbo. And this color is soft white. Also, Lion Brand Yarns Homespun. This color is pearls. Also, Soft Pink by Karen Simply Soft. I used Doris Animal Noses, the 21 millimeter size. And then I also used the Doris Solid Black Eyes, the 15 millimeter. See if I can bring that in. I just wanted to show how much yarn was left over of the fancy fur yarn so that you know that you could make definitely more than one Westie with this type of yarn. You're going to need your F or 4 millimeter crochet hook, as well as a tapestry needle and a pair of scissors. I'm using my soft white yarn first to make the snout. We're going to start with a magic circle. You just drape the yarn across your four fingers and use your thumb to stabilize, and then wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers twice and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then take your crochet hook and just go under the two loops, bring up a loop, then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle. So you go into the magic circle, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both loops for a single crochet. And we're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle. Then you're going to take your forefinger and your thumb and just hold the base of the six single crochet. And then you have the two loops on the opposite side. Just take and pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, let go and pull on the other one. But this one's closing, so you just close it gently. And then take your loose yarn end and pull on that. Now you're just going to make two single crochet into every stitch around. So you take your crochet hook, go into the first stitch, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet, and you're going to make two single crochet into the same stitch. And you're going to repeat that all the way around until you have a total of 12 and then come back. Now we're going to do our increase rounds. So you're going to need a yarn marker, and I just use one of my scrap pieces of yarn. Just place it right where you left off. Then you're going to make one single crochet into the first stitch. And then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back. Now for the next increase round, you just take your yarn marker up and you're going to make one single crochet into the next two stitches. And then in the third stitch, you're going to make two single crochet into the same stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the beginning. This is going to be our last increase round. Take your yarn marker and move it up. Now you're going to do one single crochet into the next three stitches. And then make two single crochet into the fourth stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. We just finished our increase rounds. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. Then you're going to make four rows of just one single crochet into every stitch around. So go ahead and make one single crochet into every stitch around for four rows and then come back. You should have completed four rounds of one single crochet into every stitch. Then you're going to take your crochet hook and go into the next stitch over, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for slip stitch. And then you're going to go ahead and finish off, just yarn over and then pull enough yarn through to bury into your work. Then we're just going to set the snout aside for now. For the head, you're going to use the same colored yarn as you did for the snout, and we're going to make a slip knot. So you just take your yarn and just fold it over on itself to form a loop. Then take your crochet hook and just put it right through the loop and hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and your thumb. Then just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Now you're going to make a chain of 16. One. I'm just going to show you a few so you can see how to make a chain. Just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for your chain. That's chain two. Three. Just going to show you a couple more. Four. You can see how I'm moving my fingers up and holding the chain as I work. Five. So go ahead, finish making a chain of 16, and then come back. After you make a chain of 16, you're going to hold that last stitch with your middle finger and your thumb, and then you're going to make a chain of one. We're going to move up to the next row. Then you're going to make a single crochet into the second chain from the hook, which is the stitch that you're holding. So take your crochet hook, go into that second chain from the hook, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And then you're just going to make a single crochet into every stitch back to the beginning. So I'm just going to do a few with you. Go ahead and finish making one single crochet into every stitch back to the beginning, and then this is how your work should look. When you reach the end, you're going to make a chain one, and then turn your work. And here you could see at the base of your chain one, there's a little bit of an upslope here. You're not going to work into this stitch. You're going to work into the next stitch over. And you're going to make one single crochet into every stitch back across. And then come back. When you've made your single crochet into the last stitch, you're going to chain one and turn your work and repeat the same thing until you've completed 16 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. And then come back. After you finish completing 16 rows, you should have perfectly straight edges. If you don't have straight edges, it means that you may not have had the 16 stitch count for every row. So you may have to start counting your rows initially until you get it right. But if you did yours right, then you can go ahead and just finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to bury into your work. And you're going to need two of these. So two of these, front and the back panel. For the side panel, you're going to start it the same way with a slip knot. This time, you're going to make a chain of 48. I'm just going to do a few of them with you. There's one, two. So I'm going to do a couple more chains with you. Three, four. Go ahead and finish making a chain of 48 and then come back. After you make your chain of 48, you're going to hold that last stitch with your middle finger and your thumb, and you're going to chain one to move up to the next row. And then you're going to make a single crochet into the second chain from the hook, which is the stitch that you are holding. And then you're just going to bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. And then you're just going to make a single crochet into every stitch back across. And then come back. Now, after you reach the end, you're going to chain one and turn your work. And you're just going to repeat the same thing, one single crochet into every stitch across until you've completed 8 rows. So one single crochet in every stitch and come back after you've completed 8 rows. And we'll see what your work looks like. After you finish your 8th row of one single crochet into every stitch, then you're going to go ahead and finish off, just yarn over, and then pull enough yarn to bury into your work. Now you're going to get your animal nose, and you're going to place your animal nose right. You're going to find out where you want the top of your snout to be, and I usually put the loose yarn in towards the bottom. And then I'm going to move up from the center of the magic circle. I'm going to count one, two, and then right at the top of that second one, I'm going to place my animal nose. And then I just point the tip of the nose towards the center of the magic circle. And then you can turn it inside out and just place the safety lock on the other side. And then you're going to get the stuffing for the inside of the snout. And I just use a cheap pillow for that. And I usually get my pillow from Walmart. It's a around $3 pillow. Then you're just going to set your snout aside and grab your two front and back panel, as well as your side panel. We're going to sew those together. Just get your tapestry needle and the same colored yarn. Then you're going to take one of your panels and make sure that your stitches are going the right direction and not up and down like this. You want it this way. And then you're going to lay your panel right on top of it. And if you have your two loose yarn ends together, you can go ahead and tie that. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle with the same colored yarn, and you're just going to take and sew the two pieces together, just like this. And you can tie a knot. Then you're going to take and turn your work. And you're just going to sew along the other edge. The same way. And you're just going to sew all the way across, and then you're going to fold it and sew it down the other side. And then come back when you reach the end, and I'll show you what to do next. Your work should look like this. You have the panel, the side panel sewn on the sides of the back panel, as well as the top and the other side. And then you have a little bit left over on the one side. I do that on purpose just to make sure that you get a good fit. Then what you can do, this is going to be the right side. So we want to keep the wrong side showing, which is the side that you were sewing on. And then once you have the wrong side showing, you're going to take and fold up that panel. It's going to go on the inside of the head. Make sure it's even with the bottom row. Then you're just going to take your tapestry needle and just sew it in place. Make sure that you're only sewing it to the side panel and not to the back, or this could be the back or the front, doesn't matter. Then you're going to take your other panel And I'm just going to call this the front panel, but like I said, this could be the front, this could be the back, doesn't matter. But the one that you're going to be working on next is the other panel. And you're going to take and place it. This is the right side. You're going to place it over your work just like this. And we're going to sew it in place. So you're just going to go through the top stitch and sew the pieces together. Then you're just going to sew it on the same way that you did the other side. You're just going to sew along here and then along this side and then along the other side. After you've sewed all the edges, then you just turn it inside out. And now we're going to sew the snout on. Now you should have your head turned inside out. Then you're going to take your snout that you've stuffed with some pillow stuffing, and you're going to line it up. Make sure that your nose is pointing down. The pointy part of the nose is pointing down. And then you're going to line up the bottom portion with the bottom of the head, making sure that your nose is straight. And then you're going to sew the bottom portion first. And then just make sure that as you sew it, that you're lining up the snout. You want to have the top couple rows free. You have one, two, three. So that's how I sewed mine on. And that just helps you as you sew, just make sure that you keep your nose straight. And to help line it up, that's why I sew the bottom portion first. And you could see that I come in from the inside of the head through the bottom portion of the snout. And then you're just going to tie a knot. On the inside. So come back when you're finished sewing the snout on. Or you can wait till I finish sewing mine on, and I'll come back and show you how I positioned it. This is what my snout looks like after I've sewed it on. You can see how I lined it up with the bottom edge. This is what it looks like on the one side and along the top and on the other side. And now I'm going to show you how I put the tongue on. For the tongue, we're going to start with the magic circle again. Use your thumb to stabilize and wrap around your two middle fingers twice and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then go under the two loops, bring up a loop. Then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through the loop for a slip knot. And then you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle. Then take your forefinger and your thumb and hold it at the base. And you're going to pull on one of the loops on the opposite side. If it doesn't close, you let go and pull on the other one. And then take your loose yarn in and pull on that. Then you're going to make a chain one. Then turn your work. And you're going to make a single crochet into every stitch back across. And you can see that I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochet. I have the shape of a tongue. Then you're going to finish off. Make sure you bring enough through to sew it onto the snout. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle and you're just going to position the tongue. Make sure that it's not crooked. And then you're just going to sew the tongue in place. Just go in and out along the top of the tongue only. And just sew it in place. And then you can tie a knot and then start sewing with the other end. And I just sewed mine right across the top, and that's it. You can come back out near your other loose yarn end. Then tie another knot. And then when you're done, just take your loose yarn ends, just go back in through the snout into the center of the head. Just pull your loose yarn end through. And do that for both of them. And then just straighten your tongue out. And then you have your tongue sewn on. I just tied a knot on the inside and then just cut my loose yarn ends short. And then I have my tongue sewn on. Now you're going to place the eyes. This is how I placed my eyes. You could see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stitches in between. And then once you've placed your eyes, just take and turn your work inside out. And then you could place your safety latches. They're actually not that hard. For some reason, I'm just having difficulty with that one. They're actually pretty easy to place. And then once you have them in place, then you can just turn your head back inside out. Now I'm going to show you how to make the feet. And all of the feet are made the same way. So you're going to need 4 of them total. We're going to start with a magic circle. Just take the yarn, drape it across your 4 fingers, use your thumb to stabilize, and then wrap it around your 2 middle fingers twice, and then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then you just take your crochet hook, go under those 2 loops, bring up a loop, then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make 6 single crochet into the magic circle. I'm just going to do a couple with you. Go ahead and finish making 6 single crochet into the magic circle and then come back. After you finish 6 single crochet into the magic circle, take your forefinger and thumb and just hold it at the base of the 6 single crochet, and then you have the 2 loops on the opposite side. You're going to pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, let go and pull on the other one, but this one's closing. And then just take and pull on the loose yarn end. Now you're going to make 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. So take your crochet hook into that first stitch, and you're going to make 2 single crochet into that stitch. And then you're just going to make 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12, and then come back. Then we're going to start our increase rounds. So you're going to take your yarn marker and just place it right where you left off. Then you're going to make 1 single crochet into the first stitch, and then 2 single crochet into the second stitch, and then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back. This is what your work should look like. We're going to do 2 more increase rounds. For the second increase round, you're going to make 1 single crochet into 2 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the third stitch. Then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now for the last increase round, you're just going to make 1 single crochet into 3 stitches. And then 2 single crochet into the fourth stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Then move your yarn marker up, and you're just going to do 1 round now of just 1 single crochet into every stitch. So 1 single crochet in every stitch for 1 round, and then come back. Then take your yarn marker and move it up. We're going to do a decrease stitch for the next 8. We're going to make 8 decrease stitches. So you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. You have 2 loops on the hook. Go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. You have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all 3 for a decrease stitch. And you're going to do that 8 times. I'm just going to do it with you. Then, after you finish making 8 decrease stitches, then you're just going to do 1 single crochet into the rest of the stitches, back to the yarn marker, and then come back. Now go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up, and you're going to do 1 round of 1 single crochet into every stitch. And you're going to do that for the next 13 rows. So go ahead and finish making 13 rows of just 1 double crochet into every stitch, and then come back. Now you can take and stuff your leg, and then we're going to get ready to close. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. Now we're going to do a decrease round. For this decrease round, you're going to take your crochet hook and just make one single crochet into three stitches. Then you're going to make your decrease stitch. So you're going to go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. You have three loops on your hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all three for a decrease stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Then you're just going to move your yarn marker up for the next round. And on this decrease round, you're only going to make a single crochet into two stitches. So one single crochet into two stitches, and then you're going to make your decrease stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. When you reach the yarn marker, go ahead and move it up. Now you're just going to make one single crochet into one stitch, and then make your decrease stitch. As you're closing, you can stuff the foot more if you need to. Go ahead and put some more stuffing if you need to, and then continue one single crochet in one stitch, and then your decrease stitch until you get back to the yarn marker, and then come back and I'll help you close the leg. Now you can go ahead and take away your yarn marker because we're just going to decrease and then slip stitch our leg closed. So you just go into your next stitch and then go into the next stitch for your decrease stitch. And when it gets too hard to make your decrease stitches, we can go ahead and start slip stitching. So now I'm going to go ahead after this decrease, I'm going to go ahead and just start slip stitching it closed. And how you're going to do that is you're just going to take and skip a stitch, and then you're going to work your crochet hook into the next stitch, then yarn over, and then bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And you're just going to finish doing that all the way around. One more should do it. I'm just going to go right across to the opposite side. And then you're just going to take and finish off. Just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop to finish off. And you're going to bring enough yarn through to bury into your leg. And you just need four of these little paws. You can take your tapestry needle and just put it onto the loose yarn end. We can go ahead and just bury them. Take it and go right where you tied your knot and come out anywhere on the foot. And then just pull that snugly. And then you can go ahead and trim the loose yarn end. Go ahead and make four of these, and then come back and I'll show you how to make the body. For the body, you're going to take and do a magic circle the same way. Just drape it across your four fingers. Use your thumb to stabilize. Wrap it around your two fingers. Hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. And I'm still using my F crochet hook, and I'm going to bring up a loop. Then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. And then you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle, just like you did before, and then come back. I'm just going to do one more with you. So you're going to need a total of six single crochet into your magic circle, and then come back. Then you're just going to close your magic circle the same way you did before, and then you're going to make two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. So you're just going to go into that first stitch and make two single crochet into the same stitch and do that in every stitch around until you have 12 total. Then you're going to need your yarn marker because We're going to do our increase rounds now. For the first increase round, you're going to make one single crochet in the first stitch and then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now for the next round, you're going to do one single crochet into two stitches and then two single crochet into the third stitch. And this is what it'll look like when you're done. Then for the next round, you're going to make one single crochet into three stitches and then two single crochet into the fourth stitch. So now you can see the pattern. We're going to keep increasing. The next round will be 1 in 5, and then the last one will be 1 in 6, but I'll do them with you for each round that we're going to complete. But for this round, you just need one single crochet into three and then two single crochet into the fourth. For the next round, one single crochet into four and then two single crochet into the fifth. Now one single crochet in five and then two single crochet into the sixth stitch. This is how your work should look after completing all of the increase rounds. Now you're going to take your yarn marker and just move it up. And you're going to make one single crochet into every stitch around until you've completed 20 rows. And then after you've completed 20 rows of just one single crochet into every stitch, then come back and I'll show you how to close. After you've completed 20 rows of one single crochet into every stitch, then we're going to start making our decrease stitches. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. For the first decrease round, you're going to make one single crochet into the first 6 stitches. And then you're going to make your decrease stitch. So you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the first stitch, bring up a loop, then go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, and then go through all 3 for a decrease stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. I'm almost back to my yarn marker, and I just have 5 stitches left. If you have just 5 stitches left, just make one single crochet into every stitch. And then we're going to get ready for our next decrease round. Now you're going to make one single crochet in 4 stitches and then your decrease stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way around. Now you're going to make one single crochet in 3 stitches and then make your decrease stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way around. And then you can also stuff your body at any time as you're working. Now you can see that I've already stuffed mine because we're going to get ready to close the body. For this round, you're just going to make one single crochet into 2 stitches and then make your decrease stitch and repeat that all the way around. Now you're going to make one single crochet into the first stitch and then your decrease stitch. This is what your work should look like up to this point. And now I'm just going to close the body with you. You can stuff it more at any time as you're working. And you're just going to make decrease stitches until it becomes too difficult, and then we're going to slip stitch it closed. So I'm going to stuff mine a little bit more and then I'll come back and close it with you. So here I stuffed some more stuffing into the body and now I'm just going to keep decreasing. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and just slip stitch it closed. You're just going to skip the next stitch and make a slip stitch into the next stitch over. Just take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. So skip a stitch. Actually, I'm going to go right there. That's skipping a stitch. And then I'm going to yarn over and bring it through both loops for a slip stitch. And then you're just going to do that until it's completely closed. One more should do it. And then I'm going to finish off, just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to bury into your work. To bury it into your work, you just take that loose yarn end and your tapestry needle, and then you're just going to take, go right where you tied your knot and come out anywhere on the body. Just pull it snugly, and you can see how it makes a nice closed end. And then you can just take and cut your loose yarn end. And then you're just going to set your body aside for now, and we're going to work on the ears. For the ears, you're going to start with your soft white color, and we're going to make a magic circle. Just drape the yarn across your four fingers, use your thumb to stabilize, and then wrap it around your two middle fingers twice, and then hold it with your pinky and your thumb. Then take your crochet hook, go under those loops just like we've done before, bring up a loop, then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. This time, you're going to only make three single crochet into the magic circle. There's one. Two. And three. Then you're going to take your forefinger and your thumb, just hold it at the base of the three single crochet. You have the two loops on the opposite side. You're going to take and pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, again, you're just going to let go and pull on the other one. But this one's closing, so just gently close it. Then take your loose yarn end and pull on that. Then you're going to make two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of six. So make sure that under that first stitch that you get both loops, and then you're going to make two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of six, and then come back. Then you can take a yarn marker to help you keep track. You're going to make one single crochet into every stitch around for two rows. Go ahead and complete two rows of one single crochet into every stitch, and then come back. You should have completed two rounds of one single crochet into every stitch, and it should look like this. You can go ahead and turn your work inside out so that your loose yarn end is in the center of the ear. Then go ahead and take your yarn marker, move it up. We're going to start our increase rounds. We have two increase rounds that are going to be the exact same pattern. So for both rounds, you're going to make one single crochet. Make sure you get into the stitch. So one single crochet into the first stitch, and then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then you're going to repeat that round all the way around, repeat that pattern all the way around. And then when you get back to the yarn marker, you're going to move the yarn marker up and do the exact same thing again. One single crochet into the first stitch, and then two single crochet into the second stitch, and then come back. This is how my work looks after completing two increase rounds of one single crochet into the first stitch, and then two single crochet into the second stitch. And you can see how my dog ear looks so far. After you complete that, you're going to move your yarn marker up. Then you're going to make one single crochet into every stitch around until you have completed 5 rounds. So 5 rounds of just one single crochet into every stitch around. After you've completed 5 rounds of one single crochet into every stitch, then you're just going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch over. And then you're going to go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over and then pull enough yarn through. Actually, yeah, just enough yarn through to bury into your work. And you're going to need 2 of these. You should have 2 of these made for the ears. And now I'm going to show you how to make the ear look like this. So we're going to need your pink yarn next. We're going to make a slip knot first. So you just take your pink yarn and fold it over on itself to form a loop. Then take your crochet hook, put it right through the loop, and hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and thumb. And then just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make a chain of 7. There's 1, 2, 3, chain of 7. Then you're going to take your crochet hook and you're going to go into the second chain from the hook. So you just take your crochet hook, go into the second chain from the hook, bring up a loop, 2 loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. And then you're just going to make a single crochet into every stitch back to the beginning. Then you're going to take your work and just turn it. Then you're going to go into the next stitch over. Here you could see the little upslope of the stitch beneath where you turned. You're going to go into the next stitch and make your single crochet. So that's 1, and then into the next stitch is 2, and then into the next stitch is 3, and then into the next stitch is 4. Then you're just going to turn your work, and again, you're going to go into the next stitch for 1 single crochet. And then into the next stitch for your 2nd, and the next stitch for your 3rd. And then we're going to go ahead and turn your work. Then you're going to make a single crochet into the next stitch for 1, the next stitch for 2, turn your work. Then you're just going to make one single crochet And then you're just going to go ahead and finish off. Make sure you pull enough yarn through so you can sew the pink portion onto the ear. Then you just position the pink portion onto the front of the ear. Then you have your tapestry needle on the long end that you left for sewing, or just grab the same colored yarn as the inner ear, or the outer portion of the ear. Then you're just going to sew it to the front of the ear only. So make sure you don't go through to the back. You only want it sewn to the front. And then you just sew it in place and then come back. After you've sewn on the pink portion to the front side only, then you're going to take your crochet hook and then put it towards the bottom of the ear, going through both sides. Take your soft white colored yarn and bring it through. Then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop. Go ahead and tie your knot. Then I'm going to bury my loose yarn end as I work. Just take your crochet hook. You're going to go, when you're working along the side, you're not going to be able to see the stitches as well. So you're just going to have to evenly space them as you work across to the tip of the ear. So I'm going to go into the next space over, go behind the loose yarn end, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet, and then we're just going to evenly space the single crochets all the way to the tip of the ear. I'm just going to do a couple more with you so you can see how I work my single crochets along the side of the ear. Go ahead and finish working your single crochets along the side of the ear. You can cut your loose yarn end anytime that you've finished burying it as much as you like. And then come back when you reach the tip of the ear, and then I'll show you how to turn and go down the other side. This is how my work looks so far, and I'm at the tip of the ear now. So in the very tip of the ear, I'm going to make two single crochet into the same stitch. And then I'm just going to turn and work down the other side of the ear the same way. Just one single crochet into every stitch back down to the bottom. When you reach the bottom, you're just going to finish off and bring enough yarn through to sew the ear onto the head. Now you're going to take your ears and the head, and you're going to line up the ear to sew it on. And mine, I just want to show you where I'm sewing my ear on. And this is how I take my tapestry needle, where I want to place the ear. And then you just sew your ear on. And here, I'm lining up the ear along this back row, but also I'm lining up the ear here with the inside part of the eye, and then the other side with the other side of the eye. And then I just sew it in place. This is how my ears look after I've sewn them on. I'm just going to give you a close-up. Here is what it looks like on top, excuse me, of the head. And then here's the side and also the back. And you can see I sewed the ears on well, and you want them pointing up. Here's the other side. You can play around with the inner portion of the ear. You can add a little extra couple rows here to make the point go up higher. So you can kind of play around with that if you want for yours. And then here you can see how much room I have towards the front. And I lined up the insides of the ear with the eyes and then the outer portion of the ear for the other side, just to help gauge for placement for you. After you've sewn the ears on, then you're going to take your crochet hook and you're going to go into a stitch on the side of the head. You're going to loop the same colored yarn. Make sure you leave enough yarn for tying a knot. Then you're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through that loop and tie your knot. We're going to do one round of one single crochet into every stitch. So you just take your crochet hook, you go into the next stitch over, and then this is going to be like the ear, where you're not going to be able to see the stitches as well. So you're going to evenly space them as you work and just make one round of one single crochet in every stitch. And you can use a yarn marker to help keep track. And just make one single crochet into every stitch around and then come back. Then, when you reach your yarn marker, go ahead and move it up, and we're going to start our decrease round. For the first decrease round, you're going to make one single crochet into six stitches. Then you're going to make your decrease stitch. You're going to go into the next stitch over, bring up a loop. Go into the next stitch over, bring up a loop. You have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and go through all three for your decrease. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back. Right before the yarn marker, I had five stitches left. I just made one single crochet into each of those stitches. And then you're going to move your yarn marker up for the next decrease round. For this decrease round, you're going to make one single crochet into the next five stitches and then make your decrease stitch. Then make one single crochet into four stitches and then your decrease stitch. Then one single crochet into three stitches and then your decrease. Now for your last decrease round, you're going to do one decrease into two stitches and then your decrease stitch. Then after you finish that decrease round, you're just going to take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch over, yarn over, and just bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch, and then you're going to go ahead and finish off. And just bring enough to bury into your work. Now you can go ahead and stuff the head. We're going to sew the head onto the body. Go ahead and get the same colored yarn and put it onto your tapestry needle. For the body, this is the side that we closed. We're going to put that towards the front. And then you can see the other side is going to be where the tail goes. It has a little bit of a neater stitch marking that we're going to use for the tail. And then in the front, you're going to cover anyway with fur. I'm going to show you how to do that so we can use this for the front. Just take your head and place it, position it along the front, just like this. We're going to line up the nose so that it's facing down, and then once you have it positioned the way you want it, then you can take your tapestry needle and just go in and out, sewing the head in place. And you're just going to go all around the head, sewing it onto the body, and then come back. So you can see how I'm sewing the head in place and how I have it positioned onto the body. So here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, about 8 rows from the front. This is how it looks lined up. And then I just keep sewing it until it's securely sewn onto the body. Once your head is sewn on securely, then you can take your loose yarn end and just go right in where you tied your knot and come out anywhere on the body. Then just cut your loose yarn end. Go ahead and bury all of your loose yarn ends, and then I'm going to show you how to put the feet on. You should have 4 feet completed, all of them made the same way. Make sure that the little the part that pokes out is the front of the paw. Make sure that faces forward on both of them. Take 2 of them, and then you're going to take your dog and line up a little more than halfway onto the body, and you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Make sure that they're lined up equally. Once you have them lined up the way you want them on your dog, then you're going to pinch together the 2 sides, and you're going to take your crochet hook with the same colored yarn, and you're going to go about 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to go down to the 5th row and go through the body. Make sure you don't poke yourself, and come out the other side with my tapestry needle and just grab it and bring it through. Make sure you leave enough loose yarn end on the other side for tying a knot. I leave about this much on the other side. Then you're going to go about a stitch over and then go back in and come through really close to about where you went in the first time, so you can kind of maneuver the tapestry needle so that it comes out about where you went in. You can see how I'm really close, a stitch over. And you're going to do that twice. So you're going to go back in. I like to go in twice just because it makes it extra secure. And you can see how I'm going through. And then I'm going to go right back through to the other side again. And then once you've gone twice, then you can take and puff out the arms. After you have everything positioned the way you like, then you can take and tie a knot. Then you're just going to take and bury, you go right in with your tapestry needle and bury your loose yarn ends by coming out anywhere. So go ahead, bury both of your loose yarn ends, and then you're going to sew the back legs on the same way as you did for the front. This is how I positioned my back legs. And here you can see the rows that they lie between. And I like it, this method, even though it's a little tricky. I love it because you can move the legs up and down. So make sure that you're positioned, all your legs are positioned the way you like before you move on. And if you're not happy with how it positioned, then you just pull it like this, and then you cut those little strands of yarn, making sure you don't cut your leg. Do it. But mine is positioned the way I like. So then I'm just going to bury all of my loose yarn ends, and then I'm going to show you how to become a little yarn dog groomer, and we're going to make the hair. Oh, but first we'll make the tail. So the tail, and then we'll do the hair. For the tail, we're going to start with the magic circle. So you just drape the yarn across your hand, the four fingers, and then use your thumb to stabilize. And then wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then take your crochet hook, go under those two loops, bring up a loop. Then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle, and then come back. Then you're just going to make one single crochet into every stitch around until you have the length that you want for your tail. So just one single crochet into every stitch until you have the length of your tail. If you want your tail to be the same length as mine, I'll show you how large my tail is when I come back. I finished eight rows of one single crochet into every stitch. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch over for your slip stitch. Just yarn over and pull the yarn through both loops on your hook. And then you're going to finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to sew the tail onto your Westie. Then you're going to place your tail on your dog. And the Westie usually has the tail sticking straight up, but you can put your tail however you want to place your tail. This is how I'm placing mine. And then I'm just going to take my crochet hook, go through, and come up about 2.5 rows. And then I'm going to go up into the tail on the other side. And then you're just going to sew your tail in place and then bury your loose yarn end.